Hey, what's up? I know this video is going to piss some people off, but I think that it needs to be said. A lot of people are thinking the same thing that I'm going to say, but they're not willing to admit it to themselves or willing to admit it publicly if they are willing to admit it to themselves. And that's that. You know, we've moved to beyond the point where, I'll sit here and all day and I'll talk till I'm blue in the face about how we need to, defend our liberties and work within the system that we got. But, the truth of the matter is that our liberties, our rights were tossed away by the side of the road a long time ago, and the government, looks at our rights as a translucent piece of paper that they're willing to reach right through and grab whatever they want out of there, and when in reality our rights are always they're always there. They don't go away. Your rights don't just disappear because they make a law. If you if they tell you that you can't have a beard because it's against the law. You know, that's an illegal and immoral law, because that's your property. Your body's your property. That's the very basis of all rights. All rights are based on property. And that was supposed to be the purpose of our government, was to protect private property, the basis of which is your body. All rights stem from that. So your right to bear arms, your right to the freedom of speech, your right to life, liberty, and property, those are all yours because you're not a slave. I mean, we are slaves. I'm not denying that fact, but I think that people have not been willing to admit to themselves that we have been, bearing arms to protect the rapist that's raping us. And that's a little quote from Schneebe. I think a lot of vets, especially today, Vietnam vets and Iraq and Afghanistan vets, will tell you that, we're bearing arms today. A lot of us have, and a lot of us will continue to do it, for the rapist that's raping us. And I think that, a lot of people tell me they're going to join the military when they get older, a lot of these young guys. I would never, ever pick up a rifle for this country. I would, not for the government. I would never pick up a rifle for the government ever again. I would pick it up for the republic, for the country, but not for the government. So that's a promise from me. I'll never pick up a rifle for this government ever again. So I hope that you guys understand where I'm coming from on this, and that you young guys will understand that, if you don't understand it now, when you do pick up that rifle and you go over there and you're killing all those people, those folks that none of us really want to kill, and none of you really want to kill. But some rich guy somewhere wants you to kill him. You know, you will then realize the folly of your ways. You know, and I'd encourage you guys to go check out this fella. He was a great warrior and a great man. He was an honorable man, and he was a career Marine. And his name was General Smedley Butler. So you need to go look up General Smedley Butler. Look at his record. Look at where he's been. Look at what he's done. And then go read his speech or listen to it. It's called War is a Racket. Thanks for watching.